Dave Clark followed his elder brother into a life of crime, but found redemption through an unusual means. He wrote a book about his life and has now transformed it into a punk opera and has agreed to perform it in HMP Aylesbury Prison to 200 inmates in 2015, which will be its world premiere. When Dave wrote his book about his misspent youth as a criminal, he intended to warn people against crime. But after penning his autobiography, the 65-year-old former Fareham College electronics lecturer decided that to reach more people, he needed to change format.
And so he has teamed up with a Portsmouth band, the Bootlegs,
and turned it into a punk opera. The book, Converted on LSD, tells the tale of Dave's life growing up and committing crime in Aylesbury before he moved to Fareham in 1988, and was written after his criminal brother, 2.5 years older, also turned his life around. Even a year locked away in Dover Borstal in 1967 did not make Dave stop his life of crime, and it was only after what he describes as a bad trip on LSD whilst watching the film Easy Rider in 1970 that changed his life. He claims that at that moment God saved him, and that key moment forms the focal point of his book and is the central flank of the opera Borstal Boy. As we chat in the box at the theatre, Dave looks around this old place and says, "I really can't believe we're getting the chance to put on this punk opera in this wonderful building. Having the chance to put it on here really gives my life story mainstream credibility." He adds, "The stories in the book are suited to punk. There is a strong message in the story of hope and deliverance, that life can end well. Even though I got involved in crime, I want good to come out of it. I want to teach people not to mock religion either. However, look at how many people get benefit from it. I'm only telling my story because I want good to come out of it. I'm not doing it to tell of my life because it's rubbish. There's no benefit in crime. There's no glory. You only end up in jail, and once you've got a criminal record, it's with you for the rest of your life. Looking back at the moment which changed his life and has led to this opera, Dave says, I gave LSD to 4 of my friends, and we went to see Easy Rider at the old Odeon in Aylesbury. I got the horrors and paranoia, and I was frightened of killing myself. I cried out to God saying, Jesus, please help me. All of a sudden, peace came upon me, and I heard his voice speaking to me, saying, I've been with you, Dave. You've been searching for a long time. What you've been going through is nothing compared to what hell is like. I turned my life around that night. The writer hopes that seeing artists perform this story will appeal to a wider audience. He continues, there are ways for people to turn their lives around, but they need help. I realise that people simply don't read books because they're not a quick fix. I didn't know how to get the story out, but then decided the way to do it was to turn it into a punk opera. After the 1970 conversion, it took Dave a year to work out the courage to admit to 3 years' worth of undetected crime and drug taking, handing himself over to the police. But when he appeared before the Aylesbury Magistrates Court to confess the details of his crimes, the local newspaper ran the headline, Converted on LSD Trip, and reported the details of multiple crimes for which he was not sentenced. It is the coverage of that court case which gives the book its title, along with other key moments in his journey from crime to conversion to preacher that he selected for the opera. In addition to his conversion and subsequent confession, he includes the time when he stole speedboat engines, a 44 by 24 foot builder's shed, several cars, garage equipment, and many other things. And also the refusal of the former Fareham College principal to write a foreword to his book. Now, with the help of a former student, the 12-part punk opera has taken shape. Dave says, punk itself is a means of communication, and it's underestimated. So I look at it really like a punk machine and a stage where we perform. It's like a platform and a pulpit
where we can tell the story.
It's a means of expressing emotion and a means of release. You're pent up and screwed up, but punk is a means of expressing that. The opera was originally due to have its world premiere at King's Theatre earlier this year, but its performance was postponed. But now, with the help and support of Caroline Dynage, MP for Gosport, Mark Hoban, MP for Fareham, and Dave Liddington, MP for Aylesbury, it has its world premiere in HMP Aylesbury Young Persons Prisons next year. And Dave has produced a special edition of his book called Borstal Boys, of which 250 copies have been distributed and circulating in 20 of our UK prisons. Dave wishes to take this opera on tour of the prisons in the UK and is seeking the help of a film producer to make his story into a musical film called Borstal Boys. After his conversion, Dave became a preacher and all but lost touch with his brother Michael. But in 1995, he heard in a news broadcast that Michael had been arrested in the Philippines and was sentenced to prison for 16 years. Not wanting to give up on his brother, Dave travelled to the Philippines and helped his jailed sibling to have his own religious awakening. The pair then told their story to hundreds of inmates, including New Bilibid Prison, the national penitentiary in the Philippines, Angeles City Jail, Baguio City Jail, and Baguette Provincial Jails. And they wrote a book called Trojan Warriors, which has been distributed in prisons worldwide. He says, "My brother died of TB in 2005, the year he was due to be released from prison. The only consolation to me was that he too had had his turnaround and conversion from crime to Christ just like me." Chris Owens, Portsmouth News.
It was quoted from Matthew 25:36, which says, "I was in prison and you visited me."